Well, like most actors do, I got called into the audition with a bunch of guys, and I brought what I thought was an honest interpretation of this character, and I think it resonated, and they hired me. So I was filming Days of Our Lives at the time. We were doing some Christmas episodes, so I was flying a little bit back and forth. I think one day, actually, I got done filming in Montreal at like 6, took a red eye to LA, got there at like 6 in the morning, went to the set, filmed the Christmas episode or something, then left that set and then flew back to Montreal for Secrets of the Mountain. So it all worked out, thankfully, but NBC sort of made it all happen. Both are NBC, so that kind of helped. As an actor and as a viewer, I think it's an awesome experience because what you do have, you have action, adventure, and then you've got drama, and you've got, like, we have snakes in there, and I was fortunately or unfortunately involved with the snake incident. I'm like, ah, all right, don't, you can cut that out because I'm not afraid of snakes, just for the record. No, but it has a lot of that as an actor, and then it's grounded in family. That's the beauty of it all. Aside, you know, this great, amazing, high-quality adventure, we all come back to the family, and they solve simple problems that everyone has, like across America. You know, what do they want for breakfast? Do they have cereal? Do they want cereal? Do we have milk in the fridge? And who drank all the milk? You know, these little things play into their lives, and I think that's what people can associate with. But what you have is in this mountain town, what feels like an ordinary town, extraordinary experiences happen. So I think that's what will draw the viewers in. It's got this great little Indiana Jones quality with it. It's like you use the resources, the natural resources that are around you, and your brain. You know, Kayla's a genius, and you find out this little girl is just like, how? You are just so bright. And there's that childlike innocence that sort of wakes up everybody and goes, you know what? All these wonderful things are around us. We don't need all of this crazy technology to guide us. And Uncle Henry, he brings out the old school tools. You know, he's got a great sense of history that he brings to the show as well. Because you know, some of it's rooted in truth and fantasy and adventure. And we, even as actors, get a little bit of a lesson on some history. You know what I mean? So I think that sort of perks the interest for even the parents. Like, oh yeah, no, there's a little bit without you know, banging someone over the head with a history book, it sort of creeps in there in a nice way through Uncle Henry. They had built this mine shaft that once you entered the portal, you were in, like, I felt like I was in it, really in it. We've got the torches and the rocks, and we're all crammed into this little mine shaft. And you know what you discover as well is like, oh my God, how are we going to survive this? As a family unit, even Tom, who isn't really the part of the family, but he becomes family. And how are we going to, each person has a specific role to help them through this adventure.